Hello and welcome to the International Daily Roundup with People's Dispatch, where we bring you some of the top stories from across the globe. Let's take a look at today's headlines. One dead and 200 injured amid Lebanese protests crackdown. US halts weapons sales to Saudi Arabia and UAE pending review. Biden administration to back Japan and Philippines over territorial disputes with China. Polish government enforces near total ban on abortion under new ruling. Around 200 people were injured as protests in the Lebanese city of Tripoli entered the third day on January 27th. The National News Agency has also confirmed the death of 30-year-old protester Omar Taiba in a hospital today. Tripoli is the second largest city in Lebanon and is among the most impoverished regions in the country. Security forces fired live ammunition at protesters as they demanded adequate economic assistance from the government. Lebanon has enforced a nationwide lockdown till February 8th, depriving vulnerable groups of their sources of income. The country is witnessing a surge in COVID-19 cases with 3,900 new infections and 67 deaths reported on January 27th alone. Internal security forces deployed water cannons, tear gas and rubber bullets against protesters and proceeded to open fire. At least 66 protesters have reportedly been hospitalized while several received on-site treatment from the Lebanese Red Cross and Islamic Medical Association. As hundreds marched to the Al-Noor Square in Tripoli, similar protests were held across different cities, including the capital, Beirut. Lockdowns in the country have worsened conditions for those already facing unemployment and poverty. The Lebanese currency has lost 80% of its value and inflation has risen rapidly. The government's failure to respond to the people's demands has previously also prompted unrest, including the nationwide anti-government protests in 2019. The administration of President Biden has issued a temporary suspension on U.S. arms sales to Saudi Arabia and the UAE, authorized by former President Trump. Secretary of State Antony Blinken announced on January 27th that the sales would be under review, stating that it was typical of a new administration to do so. The Trump administration had signed various arms deals with Saudi Arabia and the UAE. Most notable was the authorization of the sale of F-35 fighter jets and armed drones worth $23 billion in November last year. The deal followed shortly after the signing of the US-brokered Abraham Accords, normalizing relations between Israel, the UAE, and Bahrain. Secretary Blinken has also affirmed the Biden administration's support of the Accords. The decision to halt weapons sales has been welcomed by human rights groups who have been campaigning against the United States' involvement in the war in Yemen. The US has been widely criticized for providing logistical and military support to the Gulf states waging a long-standing war against the Houthis in Yemen. The Biden administration is also currently reviewing the Houthis' designation as foreign terrorist organization given by the Trump administration. In the meantime, it has approved all transactions with the Houthis, including crucial commercial imports. The action heeds the warnings given by aid agencies that the designation will restrict humanitarian assistance to Yemen. The Biden administration today announced its support for Japan and the Philippines over their territorial disputes with China. President Biden announced today that the US would commit to defending Japan's contested administration of the Senkaku Islands. Known as the Diaw Islands in China, they are close to the shores of Taiwan and are claimed by Beijing as being among the territories annexed by Japan during its imperialist expansion in the 19th century. The Biden administration has also reaffirmed the long-standing extended deterrence policy, which is a nuclear umbrella provided by the US to its allies in East Asia. Secretary of State Antony Blinken has also announced that the administration will support the Philippines in its maritime and territorial dispute with China in the South China Sea. While Secretary Blinken stated that it would be in the mutual interest of both the US and China to work together, the Biden administration has showed little break from convention in its China policy. Secretary Blinken had also stated that he agreed with the basic principle of President Trump's approach to China, even if he didn't agree with the way he went about it during his Senate confirmation hearing. U.S.-China relations began to deteriorate significantly under the Trump administration. Tensions emerged over issues of trade, the lifting of diplomatic restrictions between the U.S. and Taiwan, and Trump's attempts to blame the COVID-19 pandemic on China. For our final story today, we go to Poland, where the conservative government has enforced a near-total ban on abortion as of midnight on January 27th. Abortions in Poland will now be allowed only in cases of rape, incest, or if the pregnancy poses a threat to life. A constitutional tribunal has passed a ruling in October 2020, prompting massive protests. The tribunal ruled that abortions performed in cases of severe fetal anomalies would be unconstitutional. Here is a video feature on a protest following the announcement.
Jeśli do tej pory mówiliśmy o piekle kobiet, to w tym momencie chyba będziemy musiały zacząć mówić o piekle dla rządu. Po prostu zgotujemy wam piekło, nie podarujemy tego. Dzisiaj jest 27 dzień stycznia. Zapamiętajmy tą datę, bo to może być ważna data.
We have for today. For more such stories and videos, visit our website peoplesdispatch.org, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. Thank you for watching.